Hey there everyone, it's Christy and I wanted to make a quick video to say some things that have been on my mind, but I don't have time to make a full video about it. So I thought I would take this opportunity on my lunch hour while I'm walking and the day is nice to get my thoughts down. And in particular, it's on Bill Maher, rape jokes and rape culture. You might be aware that in his recent episode, Bill Maher made a joke about Michael Cohen. I'm sorry, I tried to get out of the wind here. Michael Cohen going to prison and taking a dick for Donald Trump. And what is frustrating for me is seeing the number of people who are willing to sort of say, there are people who criticize this as a rape joke. I'm thinking in particular of Liberal Viewer Presents, which is a show I generally like, but his answer to Bill Maher doing this is just to take out that joke and mentioning it, but still continuing to use Bill Maher's content, or people on social media who aren't using this opportunity to call him out. And especially as someone who has gone to bat for the idea that rape culture exists and is a problem in our society, it normalizes sexual assault, to see here is a great opportunity for people like, let's just say Noel Plum, to self-reflect on what rape culture means and what it is to engage in rape culture. The fact is that when you make jokes about men going to prison and being raped, you're contributing to rape culture because you're making it a point of laughing and normalization. You're not saying, you know, when you have a justice system, sexually assaulting people isn't considered part of the justice system. It's another crime. And so, yeah, just wanted to go on the record saying when Bill Maher made that joke, or anyone makes a joke about men getting raped in prison in particular, but anyone getting raped in prison, and diminishes it as something that's normal or something we should expect or something they deserve. The justice system isn't about doling out sexual assaults. It's about doling out justice. And I think we need to call out these types of examples of rape culture for what they are. And this makes it easier to debunk the lie that rape culture is somehow measured in rape statistics or reported rapes or rape convictions. It's the society around those assaults that rape culture, the phrase, is meant to critique. And Bill Maher's rape jokes and his perpetuation of rape culture while crying about other people being offended at what he says is a perfect example. His lack of self-awareness, his claiming to be, you know, very progressive and open-minded while perpetuating these types of harmful, sexist, and violent stereotypes of rape in prison is precisely the kind of thing that I think we should be more aware of and self-reflective of and work to identify in our own conversations and take them out, because I don't want to contribute to the normalization of rape culture. So I don't joke about rape in prison. It doesn't matter who the person going to prison is. I don't think that that is something we should diminish and belittle, because that then denies them their basic humanity. And the whole point of trying to get above rape culture is, in one part, taking down these ideas that someone deserves to be raped or they should be raped as a punishment. These are very insidious ideas that I find unsettling and against humanism. All right, I think I've made all the points I've wanted to make. I'll check the video, see how it turned out. If it's acceptable, I'll upload it. Until next time, guys, I've been Christy. You've been awesome. Thanks for listening to my thoughts on this. If you want to put your comments in the comment section below on the idea about joking about rape as rape culture and how it perpetuates rape culture or not, in your opinion, go ahead and do that. I think we should talk about the role of comedy normalizing rape in our Western cultures. So until next time, guys, bye-bye. I think I did my whole closing thing, so I'm not going to do it again. Okay, bye.